Alchemy, the art of manipulating the building blocks of the universe to create anything you want. In theory, anyway. If this reminds you of chemistry, it's because it was. Alchemists sought a great number of things, curing diseases, preventing death, but we'll move away from that to turning any worthless metal to a useful metal, usually lead, to gold. They believed that you can make anything you want, you just needed the right recipe. Which sounds fine, till you realize that these are not your ingredients, these are. While searching for that perfect recipe, many gave up, many kept going, and many claimed that you actually needed something more, something that goes beyond the five elements, the philosopher's stone. This search went on for centuries, only to be ruined by the birth of chemistry. The old five-element model of the universe was superseded by scientists in the unbelievably futuristic society of the 18th century. Ooh. Where powerful experiments suggested that yes, elements are a thing, but they're a lot more different than the ones alchemists were talking about. This led to a new atomic model proposed by John Dalton, who claimed that everything in the universe is made of atoms. Atoms of a particular element are identical to each other. Atoms cannot be broken apart. Chemical processes can only rearrange these atoms and cannot convert an atom of one kind to an atom of another. That doesn't sound too good for that dream of making gold from lead now, does it? Nevertheless, with the rise of chemistry and, scientific thinking, alchemy garnered a terrible reputation, exacerbated only by those manufacturing counterfeit gold in their attempts at making real gold. Eventually, all attempts at transmutations were outlawed, while chemistry reigned supreme. For no one could find any flaws in this atomic theory. But, like the chemists who revealed what the alchemical elements were made of, surely it is likely that somebody would come up with something similar to find what atoms are made of, right? Usually this form of reasoning is absolutely terrible, but this time, we have switched scientific settings already, from crackpot mansions to chemistry labs, so might as well do it one more time and go to a physics lab,
finally,
where Frederick Soddy and his buddy Ernst Rutherford,
guess who was more popular given the resolution of these pictures,
were trying to investigate what exactly caused radioactivity. You know, when rocks were releasing high energy radiation on their own. Soddy noticed that thorium, a naturally radioactive element, was automatically converting itself into a completely different element, radium. After some serious investigation, he realized that radioactivity was caused by this element transforming itself to another element. Sorry, did I say transform? I meant transmute, which is exactly what he told Rutherford. Rutherford, this is transmutation. For Christ's sake, Soddy, don't call it transmutation. They'll have our AIDS office scientists. While transmutation was shown to be possible, we didn't really get to any interesting places. Till 1925, when experiments involving striking radioactive nitrogen atoms with alpha particles revealed that doing so forced the nitrogen atoms to transmute to oxygen atoms. Physicists soon realized that this, along with several other experiments, suggested that no, the atom is not the bedrock, that it is possible to break an atom into its smaller constituent pieces. Which is exactly what these guys did by splitting a lithium atom into two alpha particles
using protons,
and suddenly there was hope. For while you can't rearrange atoms to make new elements, you could rearrange whatever is inside atoms to make new elements. Nearly 100 years after the Can I Make Gold Out of Anything book was closed, nuclear physics research forced it open once again, only to realize that it's easier to turn gold to lead than the other way round.
So, okay, I realized that you clicked this video with some amount of expectation that I was going to, talk about how you can make gold. Even though I have to admit, how to make gold from lead is a tiny bit clickbaity. So, here goes. While it's no lead, scientists have successfully turned liquid mercury into gold by simply placing mercury as the target inside a particle accelerator. If you don't have a particle accelerator, then you could use mercury inside a nuclear reactor where you bombard neutrons on mercury instead of uranium, which will eventually transmute to gold. Another way is by irradiating platinum, zapping atoms using some high energy radiation, which will also result in you getting gold atoms. This turns out to be the easiest way to make gold, but you start with platinum, so why bother? Finally, in the 1980s, Glenn Seaborg went to Berkeley, converted thousands of atoms of bismuth to gold, and if you look at the periodic table, bismuth is right here. Oh, close enough. This is the closest we have ever gotten to the old alchemist's dream, but like every single attempt at trying to make gold, it takes more money than what the final gold is worth.
It's not about money, it's about sending a message.
But there is one way that you will not believe that works, then nobody will tell you. It involves nuclear reactors, and this time you bombard lead atoms with neutrons and wait for a long time for it to eventually decay its way to gold. That easy.
How long? Very long.
This method would also please many who want to look like alchemists, since taking this magic material that is not made of any other element and shoving it into a worthless metal only to get this worth full priceless metal. So what are you waiting for? Ask your friendly neighborhood nuclear reactor if you can borrow it for a bazillion years and pray that humans continue existing by the time you check out. And while you're waiting for your gold, why not like this video and share this video to other aspiring modern alchemists? And before the security catches you and throws you out of the nuclear reactor, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that bell button. After all, you're gonna want more of these videos to keep you company while you're in jail. Oh boy, I hope that gold you get at the end of the line sure is worth it.
What am I doing?
Thanks for watching.